In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of sternocleidomastoid. Oh my gosh, it's very long name. This is sternocleidomastoid. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and important anatomical connection. It's very long name, sternocleidomastoid. Oh my gosh. But once you memorize origin and insertion of this muscle, it's easy to remember. Okay? So, origin is these two parts. It's from sternum. Okay? Sternum and clavicle. So it's sternocleid. Clade means sternum. Sternum and clavicle. Plus, insertion is here. This is part of temporal bone. This is mastoid process. Mastoid process. Sternum, clavicle, and mastoid process, sternocleidomastoid. Simple enough, right? This is basic attachment of sternocleidomastoid. But what do I mean basic? Anatomy book also says this muscle attaches to superior nuchal line. Superior nuchal line. Where is that? Okay, this is posterior view of head. This part is mastoid process. Superior nuchal line is about this line. Where is this line? This line is on occiput. Occiput. Yeah, occiput is back of head. This is very important to understand. Why is that? Because around occiput, there are many cervical muscles and shoulder girdle muscle attached around this area. Like a erector spinae or like a trapezius, these neck muscles attach around occiput and of course around superior nuchal line. So there is kind of myofascial connection from occiput through temporal bone by sternocleidomastoid. So when sternocleidomastoid gets tight, maybe from car accident or whiplash, this tightness can affect these neck muscles. When these neck muscles get tight, that can affect sternocleidomastoid. This is just my opinion. When I see a patient who have had whiplash, concussion, car accident, their sternocleidomastoid tend to be very, very tight. I feel their muscle is like a string, a wire, that tight. So there's no doubt tightness of this muscle can affect other neck muscles. That is why understanding insertion of sternocleidomastoid is very important. Anyhow, insertion is superior nuchal line and mastoid process. Very, very important. Now, let me explain function of sternocleidomastoid. Okay, this is anterior view. I am showing you right side only. Of course, there is on left side sternocleidomastoid. What happens when both sides of muscles contract? That brings head to extension, neck extension, head extension, however you want to call it. Extension. But I believe this muscle also can do flexion, when you do a crunch movement, sit up movement, please feel that your sternocleidomastoid actually contracts. You know, crunch movement is neck flexion and trunk flexion, right? During sit up crunch movement, sternocleidomastoid does neck flexion. On the other side, when you do a back muscle exercise, also sternocleidomastoid works. That is neck extension, right? So I believe this muscle can do both extension and flexion. It's important muscle for neck movement. Then, what happens when one side contracts? That brings neck and head to this way. This is side bend. Side bend. Plus, direction of muscle is kind of diagonal. So, that can do rotation towards this way. Okay, this is right side sternocleidomastoid. When right side contracts, that brings to left side. Right side contraction brings to left side. This is opposite, right? So this is contralateral rotation. Contralateral rotation. Contralateral means opposite direction because right side of muscle contracts, that brings to left side. That is opposite. That is why this is contralateral rotation. Review of functions. When both sides contract, that brings to neck extension. Plus, that also can do neck flexion. When one side contracts, that brings neck to side bend. Plus, the other side rotation. That is contralateral rotation. Again, this is very important muscle for neck and head movement. Now, let me explain important anatomical connection with muscle and nervous tissue. Again, this is posterior view. Do you remember? This is sternocleidomastoid that attaches to superior nuchal line. This is trapezius. If you look carefully, there is space between sternocleidomastoid and trapezius. This area. In this space, one nerve penetrates here. This is greater occipital nerve. Greater occipital nerve. This nerve is important for headache, especially around occiput area and parietal area. So when this nerve gets impingement, that can create headache around this area. But how? Okay, this is one cause. When sternocleidomastoid and trapezius get tight, maybe by a concussion, by car accident or whiplash, any head trauma or any muscle tightness around this area, that can diminish this space. What happens when this space is narrow? Then this nerve can be tight or got impingement. What happens then? Now that can create headache. Again, sternocleidomastoid tend to get very tight after head trauma. Of course, trapezius can get tight after trauma. Neck muscles get tight very easily after trauma. Then this space becomes narrower. Greater occipital nerve penetrates this space. Then what's going to happen? This nerve tissue got impingement. Therefore, there can be headache. This is very common place that people have headache. So if you are a therapist, maybe it's good to focus around this area, occiput area, and maybe sternocleidomastoid. When you have patient who have headache, maybe this area is very, very tight. It's good to check. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of sternocleidomastoid. I explained its origin, insertion, function, and important anatomical connection. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.